Alright guys, so you might be able to tell from my voice that I'm sounding a little bit nasal. That's because I caught a cold, yay! I've also got my driving test tomorrow, but by the time you've seen this, actually no, it won't be tomorrow, it'll be in like a few hours from when you see this. But anyway, so that's great, so I'm basically trying to keep my voice. So I thought I'd record this now while I can still speak, as opposed to trying to record it later when I've got a like whisper like this. So, what are you doing? That's quite accurate actually, well done. Yeah, I was going to record it when we'd done a little bit more inside the cave, but I thought I'd just do what we've done now. So I thought this area here was really lazy. We just literally chucked trees everywhere and said, oh, that bit's done. And I want to cover this entire island in just stuff everywhere, so there's always something to explore. So what we've got here is a lot of people saying, how are you going to get the ships into the water? So I thought, oh, we've got these rolling bits here. So you pop the ship on the rollers, you roll it forward, and I don't know how they're getting it to stand upright. I'm presuming they just moved like these little bits along with it. Anyway, so you move it along. So these rollers obviously roll all the way along to here. And then we have this winch house here. And you attach this plank with these chains here to the edge of the ship. And you rock the ship on its side, so it's kind of the mast is pointing over there. And then you release the winch here, and the way the winch works is it's got a water wheel powering it. That's when you're lifting something up, but obviously when you're letting it down, all you need to do is release like a ratchet or something. And there's the wheel, and it goes through this loophole to each end of this stick here, and then that will lower the ship down into the water, where theoretically you will be able to kind of bring it over here and then turn it. But I mean, realistically, I'm not sure if it could actually turn there, but hypothetically it works. Shut up. Anyway, so we've got this stream here which we tried to make look really realistic, and then when you come up here we have a cave. And originally the water covered the entire front of the cave, and it looked awful, it looked really weird, but I think this was a good kind of compromise. I might reduce the water here a little bit, that was a bit much, but apart from that. And on the inside you've just got some like kind of white vines because of the biome colouring. We've got snowballs just about everywhere, and we added lots and lots and lots of dripping water. I'm actually losing my voice, so I'll wrap it up. Thank you for watching. Say hi, you two.
Penis!
Okay. That's his trademark, that is.
Yeah, trademark, yes. Ginger Jack, the penis boy. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.
Thank you for 1,000 subs.